because I haven't done this in so long. I've been MIA. Glad my hair looks legitimately disgusting in every single video that I film. Like, hi, I don't do my hair, ever. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm filming this look today. It's like, when you don't know your colors. It's like mauve-y, purpley, pinky. Okay, Jocelyn, literally get your colors. I can't do colors. What are colors? I don't know. Also, cute chest blotch every single video. Okay, anyway, moving on. I filmed this today and yeah, literally haven't filmed in forever. Don't know how to talk. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. It would mean a lot to me, and subscribe to my channel. I try and put out videos a lot, but I always say I do and then I don't, like, for months. But I mean, subscribe anyway, cause, you know, cause just do it. Just do it. And my, if you like this video, and thank you so much for watching. And I will see you in my next one, whatever that is. Hopefully not months away, but hey, you never know. Okay, I'm done. Okay. Mwah. Bye. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So I'm starting off by moisturizing my lips because I'm going to be wearing lipstick later. And then I'm going in with my Kat Von D foundation in the shades Medium 53 and Light 44. And I'm mixing the two together because one of them's really light and one of them's too dark. So yeah, and then I'm just blending that in with a foundation brush. And I found that this foundation can be a little bit cakey, so I just make sure that I blend it in really well so that it doesn't look like I have a cake face, because nobody likes that. And now I'm just going in with my eye primer. I use the Urban Decay original one. And I just put this all over my lid so that my eyeshadows don't get all creasy and ugly and gross, because that's not cute. And then I'm going in with my Naked Smoky palette in the shade Combust, and I'm putting this in my crease for my transition shade. And I'm just making sure to blend this out really well, and I'm bringing it kind of upwards towards my eyebrow because I want it to be a smoky look as opposed to like a sharp crease. So I'm making sure I blend it out really well. And then I'm going in with my Naked 2 palette in the shade, I don't remember what it's called, but I'll link it down below. And I'm just putting that right on top of Combust and just blending it out and making it more of that smoky look as opposed to like a crisp line. And I'm doing that on both of my eyes. And then with the excess that I have left on my brush, I'm kind of just bringing it in towards the center of my eye to, again, make it more smoky. And then I just keep bringing it up towards my eyebrow because I want it to be very blended and no harsh lines. And now I'm going in with Makeup Geek's Frappe. Also, don't mind the black spots on my fingers. I'm not really sure what that is, but I'm going in with that and I'm blending that in right on top of the other two colors that I put to give it more of a deeper look. And then again, with the excess that I have on the brush, I'm just bringing it in towards the center of my eye and blending it out. And now I'm going in with Makeup Geek's Shimma Shimma, which is such a cute name. And I really love this. It's so sparkly and pretty, and it has a bit like a pink undertone. So it's not just like a basic shimmery shade, it has more of the pink look. So I thought it looked really nice with the other colors that I used in my crease. And I'm going, I'm going in with my Naked Smoky palette in the shade 13. And I'm using that for an inner corner highlight to really brighten up my eyes, because who doesn't want bright eyes, right? Right? Right. I'm literally the most awkward person on the planet. So yeah, I'm just putting that in my inner corner and blending it out. And now I'm going in with my concealer. I use the Makeup Forever HD Concealer, and I think I'm in the shade Y23. I really like this concealer. It really brightens up your eyes, and it blends out really well. I use it with a beauty blender to make it look more seamless, because I found that with a brush, it just kind of just blends into my face and you can't even really tell, but with the beauty blender it makes it look really natural and
just brightens out my eyes really well. So yeah, I'm putting that under my eyes in like a triangle shape. And then a little on my forehead, down my nose, above my lip, and then a little bit on my chin, just for the places that I want to highlight. And then I'm going with my beauty blender, and I'm just going to blend that out all over my face so that I look like I have a glow, even though I don't. But we can pretend. And now I'm going in with my e.l.f. HD powder. I have mixed feelings about this powder. It kind of leaves a white, like, trace on my face, probably because it's not a good quality powder, but I just want to use it up, so I'm still using it, but it works for now. And then I'm going with my NARS Stephen Klein palette, and I'm using the Laguna bronzer to not really contour, but just bronze up my face a little bit because I'm a little pasty. So yeah, just adding some warmth in. And when I put bronzer on my forehead, I usually don't go in the middle of my forehead. I just found that it makes it look better as opposed to putting it everywhere. And then I put a little on the sides of my nose and a little on the tip. And there's an awkward chest spot because I scratched, and that's what happens. And then I'm using NARS blushes in Blasphemy and Luster, and I'm mixing the two together and putting them on my cheeks so I have some color. You fell down by the wayside. And then I'm going in with the Paloma highlight from this palette, and it's very matte. It has like no shimmer at all, and it really doesn't do all that much, I don't think, but it brightens your face up a little bit. And then I realized I forgot to set my concealer, so I'm going in with Ofra's banana powder, and I'm just putting this under my eyes to set my concealer. And now I'm going to do my brows. I use the Anastasia Brow Wiz. I really want the brow definer because I'm kind of over this brow wiz. I mean, it's okay, but I want a different one. And my spoolie broke off of it, so I have to like brush my eyebrows with my fingers, and it's just awkward and it doesn't really work. But anyway, I use the shade Taupe, and I just fill in my brows. I don't really have any like specific technique, but yeah, as you can see, I have to like brush them out with my fingers because I don't have a spoolie. Then I'm going back with my Naked 2 palette with the color that I don't know the name of. And I'm putting that under my eye, like on my, whatever, lash line, and kind of smoking that out just a little bit. And then I'm going back in with my Smoky palette with the shade 13, and I'm actually putting that right on my waterline, instead of like a white eyeliner. I just used a powder to really like brighten up my eyes and make them pop. And this is such an awkward angle, but I'm just putting it right on my waterline. And now I'm curling my lashes, typical. I never used to do that really, but I've started doing it a lot. I feel like it looks a lot better. And now I'm putting on mascara. This is just a Sephora one. I think it's like Ultra Defining Total Complete Mascara or something like that. But I really like it. It's a good mascara. So yeah, I'm just putting that on my eyelashes. And then I'm using the Too Faced Melted Lipstick and Melted Sugar. I literally love this so much. It's like a perfect nude. It's like a little bit pink, but mostly just nude. But it doesn't really wash out like your face, so I really like it. So yeah, that is this look. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and thank you so much for watching, and I will see you very, very soon. Mwah. Bye. I'll be there for you.